puck's got to get deep. They got to get on it. They, you know, everything has to be north. If they do that, I think they're in good shape, and they must manage their risk here against Detroit.
He was making mention of the fact that Steve Yzerman, after every win, is kind of giving him some grief. Moving in, a little toe drag by Paling, puts it on net. And the backhander stopped by Billy Husso. Ruda's shot from the right point. And it's back out to center.
Oh, there's a turnover right there that leads to a quick chance for Kubalik.
Sider back across. Kubalik, another shot. Jari tested for the first time. Another takeaway. Larkin kept it onside to Perron. Back to Larkin. Shoots. Blocker save. Is made short side by Jari.
So much experience in that locker room with those three guys.
Speed through center, though. Top. Backhands one on net. Jari makes the save. It bounces out to Wallman. And he fluttered one wide. Top. Edmondson forces him, though. And once again, the puck kept deep by Berggren. And there's Sherratt first to it for Detroit. Played up high. Edmondson drops one off. A long shot by Loft is put on net and fought off by Jari.
Any type of cleanness.
Carter moves in. Shoots and a save made by Husso with the right pad.
As I say that, a good chance.
Right out in front. Nylander shoots and scores! The puck almost constantly in Pittsburgh's end. They get it out and respond. And it's the youngster put in the lineup today by Coach Sullivan. He responds as well. Nylander lights the lamp. And it's 1-0 Pittsburgh.
Nylander gets it to Carter for a good opportunity, a puck retrieval, and then Nylander in a prime scoring area. As he moves from his left to his right, is able to sift this one through some traffic and give the Penguins a 1-0 lead.
This goal should settle the nerves down for Pittsburgh, who played a lot in their own zone.
Moved by Letang. Left in the corner. Archibald takes a hit. Kubalik tries to take the puck away. Pins Archibald up against the wall. It comes free to Zarnik. He tried to go short side, or Larkin rather. Foligno across the line. Foligno, a little pirouette. Stalls and waits for help and finds Edmondson, who puts one right into the blue paint. Covered up by Jari. Off to Crosby. Ahead to Rust. Gensel goes back door. Rust the toe drag. Save made by Husso. A beautiful move from Brian Rust.
And nearly get the second. Great play here by Brian Rust.
But Billy Husso with a big save to keep it a one-goal deficit.
Milford. Chopped at by Gensel. Tracked down by Crosby. Back to the point, Friedman. Handed off to Ruda. Rister gobbled up that time by Billy Husso. As if they have no margin for error. They do have a game in hand, a couple to be exact, on these teams at the end, but they probably have to win them all. Is this off the draw, right on the doorstep? Zucker poking at it.
And have the lead here in the first period.
Carter, look to center to Zucker. Throws it into the crease. Rost hit the post. Foligno across the line. Off to Perron. Back to Sider. Seam pass on net. Jari makes the save. Perron to Raymond and back to Sider, who walks the line. Top of the left wing circle, that is Perron. Skates it straight away. Wrist shot. Blocked in front. Jan Ruda can't clear. Perron, a one-timer that sails around the glass and all the way out with 10 seconds to go in the opening period, and the power play is over.
All hands on deck with that penalty kill there from the goaltender on out.
Crosby and Steals. Scores! A giveaway burns Detroit. Towards the end of the first.
What a turning point in this hockey game. The penalty kill, the pressure leads to the turnover, and one of the best backhands in hockey that we've seen in decades. The pressure by Gensel forces the turnover in front of the Detroit net, and Crosby
with a 2-0 lead. So a little bit of a slow start, some nerves, and then it ended really well. Let's see if they can keep their foot on the gas here in the next 20.
And Leah Hextall, how nervous is the whole organization?
It seems that they are a little bit tentative about their playoff chances.
It's in deep once again. Malkin pokes it behind the net. He and Edmondson come together. Move for Raquel, not past Ernie. Loaded in on net. Edmondson knocked down to the corner by Carter. That allows Pittsburgh to control the puck. Letang a shot. Husso the save. And right on the edge of the crease, he will cover and got the stop. And now Dumoulin. He and Suter come together in the far corner. Suter wins that race. Mata point to point. Hey. Long wrister, easily gloved down by Jari.
Don't worry about the time you're spending in your defensive zone.
They did it again just there as Dumoulin, off the loose puck, moves in on the backhand, save Husso. And he paddles the rebound to the corner. Nothing that would threaten his long-term future, but he's not playing today. Wallman with a try, save Jari. Taking the loose puck was Crosby. Outlets Heinen. Bouncing puck, hoping for a return. Crosby, a backhander. Save it by Husso. Rebound, score! Heinen crashes the net, and Crosby gets another point, and it's 3-0 Pittsburgh.
Sider puts it off the outside of the net, transition. The pass by Heinen, and sauce pass that gets to Crosby somehow, and Crosby with that backhander gets it on net. The second effort to poke this puck right there. And that works it free, and Heinen able to knock it in. I think that puck is below the crossbar, will be a good goal. And boy, is that ever a big goal for the Penguins to get some breathing room in this game. Great second effort there by Crosby, and Heinen puts it away.
The consistency his entire career has been amazing. Letang at the right point. Taken away by Kopp. Possible two on one. Suter to his right. Suter finds the trailer. Back to Kopp. Suter scores! Tick, tack, toe! Detroit's on the board!
It can cost you. Here, Letang, the turnover at the blue line. And he tries to win the puck at the blue line on Kopp. Kopp out muscles him. And then a terrific passing play here between Kopp, Suter, Raymond, and then the finish by Suter. A terrific passing play by Detroit to narrow the deficit to two after the Heinen goal.
That is as pretty as a passing play in the NHL can get.
And Boosh, to your point, it's great that Crosby is showing up today because sometimes...
Again, Pittsburgh does not have the regulation win tiebreaker with either the Islanders or the Florida Panthers. He may have been disrupted by Billy Husso. Looked like he tried to go between the legs. Crosby in the left wing corner. Up high to Letang. A return to the captain. Crosby shoots. Score! 1,500 career points for Sidney Crosby. His second goal of the game. And it's 4-1 Pittsburgh.
Retrieving pucks, and then eventually Crosby gets it. And what a perfectly placed shot. We saw the backhander earlier in the game.
Malkin, one hands one right into the blue paint. And Valeno back the other way. Had his pocket picked by Malkin. Malkin right between the circles. On net sucker. The rebound. Put home. Score. It's Malkin. He deserved it. What a hard-working shift by Evgeny Malkin. And he gets a goal of his own with 7 minutes to go.
Malkin hangs onto it, loses it, and then wins the puck back and makes a great feed and then goes to the net. And when you go to the net, oftentimes you can find some loose change. And that's exactly what happens as the Red Wing player, Joe Valeno, not able to have a strong enough stick. Malkin puts it away, and he started the whole play with the carry into the zone and the Penguins.
Nylander, center circle, Poehling brings it across. Nylander gets a return. He's got a goal, looking for another save made by Billy Husso with 20 seconds to go. Down to 2-1, and there is the horn to make it official. A very complete 60-minute performance by the Pittsburgh Penguins, and they win it 5-1.